Okay, now I will explain you how to work with restaurant POS. So you can log in with your user ID. Here I create the user ID 1001 and the password 123. So we have tables and we have table groups. So if it is takeaway, I will select the table group takeaway and I will book it in any table. If it is dining, I can select the tables here. If it is a delivery, maybe I have 6 drivers, I will assign to any driver. So here I select table 1 and these are the groups: juices, cocktail, VIP, stopwatch. Okay, so the options I will tell you. Number of guests, here you can mention how many guests are there in this table, so it's just for information purpose. Discount, if you want to give any discount, you can enter the discount amount here. See, and price change, if you want to change the price for this particular item, now it's 70, you can click price change, and I want to change this to 20, so that will change. Quantity, now you want to select this Samadhi. I need 5 pieces. So first I will click the quantity button and I enter the quantity. Then I will click the Samadhi. So the quantity 5, product Samadhi, and price will be there. Served by, here you can select the supplier name. Cancel order, of course you can cancel all the order in one click. Void, if you want to void this particular item, you can click that item, then click void, so that will cancel from the order. Hold order, now it's in hold. You can close and you can start take order from another table. So you can see here it's in red mark, that means it's already booked. Now I select table 2 and I select many items. Now I click the button order. When we click this button, order button, that time if they are using KOT, they will get the print in kitchen. Okay, so after clicking the order, I put it in hold, so it's in green mark. So the difference between this green and red, green it means this order already placed and put in hold. Red means we just take the order but we didn't place the order and we put it in hold. So now I select this order again and I add some more items and I click order, hold again. So that changed to green. So once they finish the order, when they want to check out, we can go back to the same table and click tender. So here you can enter the amount. Okay, so system will show you the balance. If you click print, it will print. If you click save, it will just save in the records. That's it. In case of delivery, you can select the delivery button. And here you have to enter the customer mobile number. Click. Let's say existing customer, the name will come automatically. Otherwise, you have to enter all the address. Then click save. And there is another option, kitchen memo. Now I select this Nutella floating. So customer want to add more sugar. So I'll click kitchen memo. And here I have the option other memo. I can type anything here. So it will print with that particular item. If you want to predefine the kitchen memos, that's also possible. From back office, you can create a master for kitchen memos. So the group, you have to create like kitchen memo, and under that you can create the categories. So all that category will come here, and all the items what you create in under that category, that will show here. You can directly select it from here. If you want to customly type that time, you have to go to other memo.